How's it going, everyone? Today we're gonna make a video and we're gonna answer one of the questions we got here. Bill M wrote to us saying that, "My name is Bill. I watch many of your YouTube video about Alaska and they're all really good. I'm into guns. I'm a former Marine. Thank you very much. I'm also a Jeep owner and off-roading. My wife, we are seriously thinking about moving from Florida to Anchorage. My wife is Japanese. I'm Caucasian. We are wondering how the Asian-Japanese community is up there." Again, a great video. Thank you very much for that question, Bill. So the question is, how is the Asian/Japanese community in Anchorage, Alaska, or in Alaska in general? So let's go ahead and talk about it, guys. I got some numbers that came up from the Alaska population here. This is all the source for this numbers here are all from the Department of Labor and Resource, and also on Google. You can go Google it. So I just did a quick Google. So let's take a look at some of the numbers. The Alaska population since 2020 is roughly about 729,000 people. So there's roughly 729,000 people in Alaska. In Anchorage alone, there's roughly about 288,000. In Kodiak, about 13,000. The reason I'm saying Kodiak, and I'll bring that back up in a bit. Kodiak, about 13,000 people. Fairbanks has about 97,000 people as of 2020. Now the population, the numbers could have went down a little bit, went up a little bit, depending on how statistics has been in the last year. The Asian Alaska population is roughly about 46,000. These are all numbers that has been rounded. So that makes about 6.2% of the population of Alaska. Filipino makes about 4.4%. Chinese, 0.3%. Laos, Laotian, 0.2%. Japanese, 0.2%. Indian, 0.1%. Vietnamese, 0.1%, and Thai, 1%. Keep in mind that there are other type of Asian in Alaska that is not listed on here that they make the other rest of the percentage. So, for my opinion, now that we have some of the numbers over with or gone through some of the numbers, you can research those numbers for yourself. Now, let's go through some of my personal opinions on what I've noticed in Alaska, living in Anchorage for almost 12 years now, 10 plus years now. The Asian community here in Anchorage, Alaska is definitely, there's definitely Asians here, but everyone is not super tight as that's the way I see it. There's no Chinatown like you would see in San Francisco, Washington, stuff like that. I know if you go to Midtown, Anchorage, Alaska, you do see more Oriental stores, more Asian restaurant kind of center in one section, but it's not really a Chinatown or an Asian town or anything like that. As far as the Asian community, the Hmong community, I mean, back then we used to have like the Hmong New Year and stuff like that, but now we have really cut back on that stuff. I do notice that Japanese, Filipinos, and Koreans, they do make up a lot of the population of the Asian community in Alaska and also in Anchorage alone. And then speaking about Kodiak earlier, the reason why I mentioned Kodiak because there are a lot of Filipino in Kodiak, or not a lot, I can't say a lot, but as far as what I've heard and what I've seen from some people that I know that are from Kodiak, I know there's a good amount of Filipinos and Kodiak because a lot of those guys are into the commercial fishing or anything that's related to the fishing industry in Kodiak. I do know some personal friends that have moved away from Kodiak to Anchorage, Alaska now. As far as Chinese, there is definitely a good population of Chinese too. A lot of Chinese restaurants, a lot of Chinese stores in Anchorage, Alaska. When you go up to Fairbanks, you do see Japanese and stuff like that too. I know for Anchorage, Alaska, when there's like a big tourist season where a lot of Japanese or Asian-oriented people come into Anchorage, there's a lot of places that's catered to that. Like I know if you go to the China Hot Spring, you'll see like a lot of writing and signs and label that are translated into Japanese. And the reason why they do that because they get so much traffic from that Asian community where it's better to just write down labels and signs and information stuff in their language and translate it, so it makes it much more easier. You can definitely come check out the scene up here. Like I say, the Asian community, there is definitely a scene, but it's not as big as any other place. Like I say, in California, Seattle, where you will go find a Chinatown, a stuff like that. You know, you'll find churches and stuff like that are catered to like Korean churches. I'm not sure there's any Chinese churches, but I know for sure I've seen like a Korean dedicated church and stuff like that. So you'll see that community if you're in that group or if you want to know more about that group and stuff like that. As far as Japanese community, I haven't really seen, or I don't really know too much Japanese people in Anchorage, Alaska, to be honest. I know, for me personally, I know I see Indian, Chinese, Filipino, Hmong, Laos, Vietnamese, Thai, and Chinese too. The other thing that's really nice about Anchorage, Alaska is that since we have our military base here, the Fort Richardson base, you get a lot of traffic, a lot of military family that are from everywhere. You know, you got people from downstate and stuff like that. You get people from all over the country. So there's that, that plays a big role too, as far as in Anchorage, Alaska, or Fairbanks, Alaska, the two main military base in Alaska. So you get that a lot, where you'll get like an Asian population or people, family that are in the military that might be Asian background and descendant. They'll come up to Alaska, and usually depending on their contract, whatever the case may be, they'll be up here for 2-3 years, 2-4 years, 5 years, and then they'll move out or whatever the case may be. So I highly recommend, if you are trying to think about moving here, definitely come visit first. Definitely come visit first and try and do a little bit more research if you want to find out more about your particular background. But definitely come visit first. I always try to tell people, come visit in the summer, and if you can come back again in the winter time, see how that is, see how you like it. Especially for somebody that's coming from Florida, where you're definitely like a yin yang, where you're coming from a whole different place, where your weather is all nice and warm and cozy coming to Alaska. So make sure you come to Alaska and check it out and see if you like the winter before you make the commitment. And besides that, Alaska, or Anchorage, Alaska, or in Alaska in general, is a very, very diverse community. You'll see all different types of race in Anchorage. I mean, you'll see white, black, Asian, Hispanic, Polynesian, Samoan, Jamaican, Somali, everything, man. You can find mostly every different type of race, Russian, German, all sorts of race here. But in this particular video, we're just talking about Asians. So Anchorage is very diverse. And again, there is definitely an Asian community here in Anchorage, Alaska. But again, it's very small. And again, it's nothing super big. Like, you don't get anything super big. I remember a couple years ago, almost like 10 years ago back there, you know, there used to be like the Asian Park, the Hmong Park, the Laos, the Mien Park. I remember back we had all that stuff, but then now everything's just more relaxed. I don't see like the community, like each particular different Asian community, they don't really come together and do anything particular nowadays, at least what I've seen. But that could just be from different perspectives and stuff like that. So hopefully this video has helped you guys get a little insight on the Asian community here in Alaska, and particularly most likely Anchorage, one of the biggest city in Anchorage in Alaska. If you guys got any questions about the Asian community or anything like that, or if you guys have any more info, leave it in the comment section below. And if you guys are wondering if there's any other particular race like Samoan, Polynesians, or other ethnic groups, let me know and maybe I can find somebody in that particular ethnic group, and maybe we can do an interview one-on-one and they can give you a better insight on that particular Asian race in Alaska and Anchorage. Talk to you guys then.